take it and remix it all over again. Create your very own Super Summer CBBC logo movie. You've mastered it, now mail it.
Each week, we'll even put some on TV.
So what are you waiting for?
Go over to the CBBC website, click on Create, and get mashing!
We are on a mission to find the world's next great superhero. 13 wannabe heroes. All battling to become the world's next great superhero. And the one who proves they have what it takes will star in their very own comic book created by Stan Lee and claim comic book immortality. Today, notorious supervillain Dr. Dark gets too close for comfort.
Where are your precious Sam and Mark? I'll show you.
Oh my God!
Leaving the superheroes to think on their feet.
I think I know the code.
What?
It could be
6 7 7 0 0 3.
We need to discuss this.
It's locked up. Right.
And we say goodbye to one more superhero.
The superhero who will power down and leave the lair is...
This is Who Wants to Be a Superhero. Superheroes have powered down.
Flying Feather.
Mega Might Man.
Dolphin Girl.
Ms. Dungarees.
Nine Lives.
Santh.
And left the lair for good. Now just 7 remain and all have faced the power down.
Not only did you fail to help the old lady and the tourist, but you did so with a smile on your face.
I'm going to show someone that I can be the ultimate superhero.
Turning your paper over was a blatant rule break.
I really do feel that I've got more to prove.
You seem to lose sight of the main purpose of this mission.
Every single person wants to actually win our trip to Hollywood and meet Stan Lee.
You revealed several key points during the press conference.
I'm really, really glad to be here.
And you certainly weren't thinking like a superhero at that meal with Abs and Rani.
I've always wanted to be a superhero since I was little.
You need to focus on the job in hand.
But I really want to pull through and do my best.
It's disappointing that we're having to repeat our feedback.
I really don't want to go.
They have all survived the power down and now the chance to claim comic book immortality is getting ever closer. So, who will have the strength, courage and integrity to succeed and become the next great superhero? It's a new day in the lair, and the superheroes appear to be full of energy.
Right, ladies, we're gonna work on our abs. Here we go. Squat. 1, 2, 3, 4, and squat. 1, 2, 3, and squat. 1, 2, 3, and squat.
Let's cycle.
Oh, you're doing great, Lorraine.
Looks like not all the superheroes are fully limbered up yet.
Mark, could you open the door, please? My hands are full. Mark! Mark, what are you doing? Mark? What are you saying? What? Mark, what's going on?
Ha ha ha!
Hello, Super Zeros. Bet you didn't expect to see me, did you?
No.
And where are your precious Sam and Mark? I'll show you.
Sam and Mark? They're in the control room. It might be a trap.
They obviously look really distressed.
But they're only downstairs. We can just go down there.
Yeah, no, it's not. It can't be that simple. Just go down there.
Not so funny now, are they? And when my mega laser beam hits them, it will result in a brain meltdown so massive, they'll have no recollection of you, me, or Stan Lee.
Oh!
We've
got
to go. We have to go. We literally, come on, we need to.
Come on, man!
Hold on, look around.
Yeah, look around for clues.
What was that on the top of the stairs? That was
exactly.
Just look around, look for something.
Guys, I think we need to go back upstairs and discuss the plan right now.
We'll be with you soon, boys. We'll get there. Come on.
Come on, everybody, quick upstairs.
We need to actually think. We've got nothing to leave.
It's
got to
be something.
What is that?
Wait,
he's back. He's back.
What is that?
Right, let's just listen.
So, there is a new lock on the control room door, and only I know the code. But if you can crack my riddles, you'll have the code to release your precious presenters. I doubt you'll have the brain power, stupid heroes. Okay. Here's an easy one to start with. The first number you need can be found at the bottom of a face that has hands but no eyes. I'm talking about a clock, of course. And number 6 is at the bottom of that.
A clock.
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 Clock. Clock.
Look at the clock.
Six. Six.
One.
Six.
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 Six. Six.
So, that pink puffle girl has managed to solve my first riddle. Well, that was an easy one anyway.
She got six.
This is good teamwork. Oh, yes, he's back.
Let's see how you do with this trickster. I am an odd number, but take one letter away, and I become even.
You said take one letter away.
The answer is 7. If you take away the letter S, you're left with the word even.
Think of letters. Letters, odd numbers. I think I know the code.
What?
It could be 1. No.
Why don't you take a letter? You take a letter off each number and then put the letters together, and it becomes evil.
Now I've got them, and with my laser beam getting ever closer to their precious Sam and Mark, time is running out.
Right, we're thinking 2. Hold on. Let's think easy.
Tick tock, superheroes. Tick tock.
F-I-V-E 5 7 S-E-V-E 1 C 7.
Even is in 7. Even's in 7.
7 7 7.
Even is in 7.
Yeah, I love you.
Well, that pink schmuffle girl's definitely smarter than she looks.
6.
Even is in 7. Even's in 7.
7 7 7.
Even is in 7.
Yeah, I love you. Right, somebody take in exactly what he says.
Luck is clearly on your side, but can you figure out this conundrum? If you dig a hole 2 meters square by 2 meters deep...
I've done this, Zero.
How much dirt is in it? The answer is 0, because if you dug a hole, all the soil would have been removed.
Because if you've got a hole and you how much soil's in it, well, there's no soil in there because it's a hole. Zero. We've done that. It's good.
Yes, it's a 6.
Since when did they start teaching supervillain riddles at school?
2 by 2, dig, no soil.
Yeah.
Yeah, perfect.
It's back.
Right.
That's one.
So I'm taking exactly what he says again, because that worked.
See if you can get this one, super losers. The day before yesterday, I was 25. And next year, I'll be 28. What day of the year was I born? In my book of riddles, this is one of the toughest. The answer is, I was born on the 31st of December. So, add 3 and 1 together, and you get 4.
29th of February.
He said 2 days from now,
I was 25.
The day before yesterday, I was 25.
He could have just been lying and said his birthday was yesterday.
You better be quick, Super Zeros, or Sam and Mark will be lost forever.
Hold on, no, he didn't say my birthday was 2 days ago, did he? He just said,
no, he said
I was 25 2 days ago.
Time is ticking, superheroes.
This one is actually quite hard.
Right. Oh, I don't want to say it. But
What? Say it.
I think we should... Right, everyone's first instinct. What did you think it actually was? No. Even if it's a guess, just what do you think it was?
I would have thought it was either 3 or 4, but...
What about you, Silent? 3 or 4. Deflector? Deflector?
What am I? 3. 3.
What do you think?
They don't have a clue, and my laser beam is less than a meter away.
I think we should go down and see if there's any clues near the door or anything.
Yeah. Right, sure. Yeah. Let's try and work it out.
Okay. We said 6703 first. Right, do we all agree?
We're coming in!
Right, should we do three? Should we do three again?
Yeah, right.
Okay. 6 7 7
0 0.
Are
you
sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that alright?
The superheroes only have 3 attempts. If they mess up now, world domination will be mine.
So, Mark, he's still there.
Should we try 5 or not?
I'm just trying to think. Is there anything that's ever happened on the 6th?
Of the 7th?
Of the
2001.
Whatever.
Try to.
No! Only one chance left, and my laser beam is just inches away.
We should try 2 because we worked it out 2 days ago.
And 11 equals 2.
Please, can we try 4? That pink puffle girl has said number 4.
Please, can we try 4?
But fortunately, no one is listening to her.
We're not taking guesses.
We are.
We need to think about this completely logically.
4.
Look, there's something there. 1741.
They don't have a clue.
That's nothing to do with anything that we've done, so it can't be that.
Those superheroes aren't as stupid as I thought. But don't worry, I'll be back.
You're gone as superheroes. How did you get the code?
We got riddles.
Yes. Hey guys, bad news. Dr. Dot knows the location of the lair.
Oh no!
You've definitely got to be extremely careful from now on, superheroes. It's a good job that you guys were here to save the day. You can all go back up to the lair. Cheers, guys.
Thank you. See you guys. You guys okay?
Yeah. See ya. Poof! That was a close one.
I know, yeah. Where's that cup of tea?
Well, it'll be cold now.
Oh, I'll go make another one.
You make one?
Oh, all right then.
Guess I'll make it then.
So, thankfully for us, the superheroes managed to crack Dr. Dark's code and rescue us from his mega laser beam.
Yeah.
But to do so, they had to work out Dr. Dark's riddles, which required thought and good teamwork. So, how did they compare? Well, Pink Puffle Girl was the first to correctly guess 3 out of the 4 numbers for the code.
1, 6, 6.
Even is in 7.
Even's in 7.
Please, can we try
4.
Princess Poor also solved one of the riddles.
Well, there's no soil left, is it?
Yeah, because it's a hole.
Deflector offered up the least amount of suggestions of all the superheroes.
Even if it's a guess, just what do you think it was?
I would have thought it was 3 or 4, but...
Deflector?
Up in the lair, the superheroes discuss Dr. Dark's riddle mission.
So who do you think performed
well?
I even said this in lair camp, I think you performed the best.
Who? Me?
Yeah, you did. Really good.
Why?
Because everyone was talking about, right, the leap year, loads of things outside the box. And then I said, right, it could be really, really simple. And then you took that into consideration. Do you think anybody, like, didn't do as good as anybody else?
I don't think anybody did badly, but I think...
The person who wasn't really interacting with everyone.
Yeah, no, the person who wasn't really participating would probably be Deflector.
I'm quite disappointed really with Deflector because he kept saying afterwards that I didn't contribute. And in the middle of it, he just sat there staring into the floor. And I was like, well, yeah, you mean that you didn't contribute, but you could have done quite easily.
I don't think the last question went.
For me, bad.
Why?
Because I didn't help.
No, you did. Everybody contributed. And...
I think you did well in the...
Me?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, you did communicate a lot and help with the clues.
Yeah, but I don't think I did as well as maybe some of the others.
Coming up, find out what happens when the superheroes think no one is watching.
So you're from London?
No, from Huddersfield.
Oh, are you?
Spit my hand off.
They make their television debut.
I think his mission is to basically have world domination over everything.
Really?
That is the thing that scares everyone.
And destroy everyone. And destroy all superheroes.
Plus, one more superhero will leave the lair for good.
It is essential that a superhero is able to interact and communicate well with the public. Unfortunately, he didn't demonstrate that in the makeup room today.
Okay, we'll be there as soon as we can. Okay, bye.
Sorted. We have got to get to BBC Television Studios as soon as we can. Come on, let's go.
1 minute.
Why? What are you doing?
Well, the superheroes are going on national TV to warn the public about evil Dr. Dark. So, I thought I'd draw an artist's impression of him, so the public know what to look out for and how to spot him.
Mark, that is brilliant. I am taking back all the times I ever called you an idiot. Let's have a look. Mark, I'm taking back all the times I ever called you an idiot. You're an idiot.
Well, come on, we're gonna be late.
When the alarm sounds, the superheroes must report to the control room immediately.
Hello, superheroes.
Hi.
First of all, well done for saving Sam and Mark. That laser beam could have caused serious damage if you hadn't cracked the code in time. But your work isn't done yet. You have a very important mission to carry out today. You are all due to appear on national television to tell the world about your superhero character, and also to warn people about your archenemy, Dr. Dark, who is still at large somewhere in the city. Superheroes, your cars are waiting for you, so be on your way.
Let's go. Ah, home sweet home, eh?
It certainly is, Mark. It certainly is. But remember, We're here today because our superheroes are going to do a very important mission. They are going to appear on Newsround to warn the world about the evil Dr. Dark. And it's the first time they've actually been to a television studio. So let's hope they're on their best behaviour and act superhero-like at all times.
Oh, at the BBC!
Come on, you. So, for this mission, the superheroes will be interviewed by Newsround presenter Gavin to tell the world about the evil Dr. Dark. However, this is only part of the mission. What the superheroes don't know is that along the way there will be a series of hidden tests. For example, in the makeup room, we have set up two secret cameras, one here and one here. This means we can see what happens when the superheroes think no one is watching. Since arriving in the lair, we have warned the superheroes about the importance of not revealing personal information. So, let's see how they get on. First to collect their visitor pass is SGW.
Hi, can I sign in, please?
Yes, you can. I need to give you a pass. What's your name?
SGW.
Okay, having trouble. What's your full name?
SGW.
Odd name. There you go.
Good start by SGW. He wasn't caught out by that question. The next superheroes to collect their passes are Pink Puffle Girl and H2O Man.
Need to give you a pass. What's your name?
My name's Pink Puffle Girl.
What's your full name?
Pink Puffle Girl. I'm H2O Man.
Oh. Thank you.
What's
your full name?
That's my only name, Pink Puffle Girl.
Oh.
Thank you.
So far, so good. Both were assured and confident. Up next is Gold Starlet, the youngest of the superheroes.
I need to sign in.
Okay, what's your name?
Gold Starlet.
Okay, I don't have that. What's your full name?
That question's thrown her.
I mean, is it not Gold Starlet then? Is it,
No, I don't have that.
Is it Ella?
What was that?
Gold Starlet then. Is it,
No, I don't have that.
Is it Ella?
Oh no, she's told the receptionist her real name.
Hello,
Steel man. Soldier is next. Let's see how he does.
What's your name?
My name's Steel Soldier.
I haven't got that down here. Have you got full name?
That's pretty much my name.
Steel.
That is my name, Steel Soldier.
Steel Soldier.
Oh, that's it. Thank you.
Thanks.
He wasn't giving anything away. The final two superheroes are Deflector and Princess Paul.
Okay, what have you got? What's your full name?
James.
Full name?
Charlie.
James.
Charlie.
Oh dear, they've both revealed their secret identities.
Hello.
Welcome to the BBC television studios. Now, today you're going to make an appearance on Newsround. Now, you're going to tell the world about your superhero characters, but more importantly, warn the world about the evil Dr. Dark and the chaos he's been causing in the city. Now, you'll be meeting Newsround presenter Gavin in the following groups. SGW, H2O Man and Deflector, Princess Poor and Steel Soldier, and Pink Puffle Girl and Gold Starlet. Now, before your big TV appearance, you're going to go up to makeup. All happy? Good, okay. We're gonna get off. We'll see you soon. Good luck. Now remember, in the makeup room we have set up two hidden cameras, which means we can see what happens when the superheroes think no one is watching.
How are you?
Oh, well, thank you.
Good for you.
First in is H2O Man. Let's see how he gets on.
How you doing?
I'm good, thanks.
You look good.
I think you're going to make me look better.
Yeah. What's your name?
H2O Man.
H2O Man. That's a very cool name.
Thank you.
So you're excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited. I can't wait.
Have you worn makeup like this before?
Only when I'm messing around. I'll have like a big spot there and then I'll pop it and it'll have like a red mark and then I'll put foundation on it.
Oh, really? Okay.
So
what do your friends think about that?
They don't know.
They don't know.
Don't worry, your secret is safe with us.
Where are you from then? Do you live in London?
I can't tell you.
Oh, you can't tell me?
No, it's secret.
Is it?
Yeah. Even if there's not a camera about. It's secret.
H2O Man is not giving anything away today.
It's just...
Next thing to make up, a deflector and SGW.
So you're going to go on news round? You excited?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're nervous? A little bit? I would be. I was saying news round used to be on when I was little. It's a big, big programme, isn't it? So I'm just going to do some powder for you.
OK.
Nothing too exciting. You're not going to get any mascara, any lipstick.
Please don't. Because my cousins do that to me all the time.
Do they? Well, they put makeup on you.
If only he knew we were watching.
There we go.
What's your favourite thing about being a superhero?
No, I don't know.
Deflector is unusually quiet.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Have you been on news round before?
No.
News round used to be on when I was little. I used to want to go on it.
You're very quiet, aren't you?
Sorry, I'm a bit chatty.
Deflector doesn't seem to want to talk to the makeup lady.
Okay. Who made your outfit, your mum? That's brilliant. You good to go? Let me just check, look in the mirror. Nice and smiley. Good, you're gonna be brilliant.
So, our superheroes have been briefed, they've got the makeup on, and now it's time for them to get interviewed on Newsround.
But they've got no idea that we're watching them here in the gallery and monitoring their every move on and off camera.
After all, a superhero is never off duty.
Remember, the aim of the interview is to tell the world about the evil Dr. Dark.
All right, guys,
remain modest and do so in a friendly superhero-like way. The three of them look like superheroes, but will they behave like superheroes? Let's find out.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hi there, and welcome to News Round. Now, you guys are part of a wave of superheroes saving the country at the moment. Tell me a bit about yourselves. What's your name, for example?
I'm H2O Man.
My name is Deflector.
My name is SGW, which stands for Stop Global Warming, and basically, stop global warming and protect the Earth.
Good start.
Excellent stuff. So, what's been your most difficult mission so far?
Being a superhero.
Really?
Yes. Yeah. I agree.
And anything in particular?
Fighting this bad guy who we're after.
Without, so who is this bad him, guy then? Yeah, what's his name? What's he all about? What's he doing?
We kind of really need to stress this because this is a very important matter. And his name is Dr. Dark.
Dr. Dark, okay.
Dr. Dark. Basically, his name lives up to his name. He wears a big, black, long cloak.
Does
like the Grim Reaper. You can't really see his face.
Right, okay.
They swiftly moved on to Dr. Dark.
Dr. Dark, he has his henchmen, which, like, have like pig noses and they're really tall.
They're working well as a team, all getting their points across.
Why is he so evil?
He is probably the most evil person you will ever see. And I think his mission is to basically have world domination over everything.
Really?
That is the thing that scares
everyone. And destroy all superheroes.
And like the fact of just thinking about them is quite scary, really.
They look like professionals.
So do you think you guys have got much chance of stopping him then?
I think we have a good chance because we're superheroes with superpowers.
Very good. Yeah. Okay, well, thank you very much for coming on. It's been a pleasure having you on the show again, and best of luck with everything, and good luck fighting Dr. Dark.
Okay.
Thank you.
That's a good start from the first team. Next thing to make up, a gold starlet and pink puffle girl.
So tell me more about your character.
We do like tasks every day.
Yeah.
I mean, like different tasks. And my superhero can like catch people with a rope from the belt.
Really? Mm. That is so cool.
Is that my belt?
Honestly? Gold starlet.
Yeah.
That is so cool. I bet your friends are well jealous.
Gold Starlet is in a chatty mood, but hasn't revealed anything she shouldn't.
You're gonna put some gloss on your lips. Are you happy with gloss?
Good.
So you're from London?
No, I'm from Huddersfield.
Oh, are you? So you're down in the big smoke?
Yeah.
Do you like
Oh no, we spoke too soon.
So you're from London?
No, I'm from Huddersfield.
Oh, are you?
Yeah.
Gold Starlet has revealed where she lives. That's the second time she's given away personal information today.
London's better than her. Are you used to having your makeup done?
No.
No?
No,
well,
I do it at sleepovers.
Did I detect a Bristol accent there?
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Did I detect a Bristol accent there?
Yeah. Yeah.
Pink Puffle Girl has also revealed her hometown.
I'm from...
It's now time for their interview, but will they remember what they're here for?
Now, you're part of a gang of superheroes helping to save the country. Yeah. Tell me a bit about yourselves. What are your powers?
Well, I'm Gold Starlet, and my powers are to, like, get rope from my belt and tie people up with it. I'm Pink Puffle Girl, and my powers are a supersonic scream.
A supersonic scream? Wow. Do you want to give us a demonstration of that? Go on then. Right, okay, I think I'm deaf in my left ear now.
Nearly deafening the presenter isn't wise during an interview.
What are your catchphrases?
Puffle power.
Puffle power. Say it to me, like you mean it.
Puffle power.
Puffle power. Wow. Any other catchphrases? We must have some more, surely. Go on then. Go on then.
I've got this, Gold Star, go thing on. Where you go bam, but like
show,
a bit more.
Go on, yeah, go on, go on. Show me.
Bam.
Bam.
They seem to be enjoying themselves, but still no mention of Dr. Dark.
Oh, I think I've got it to a T. Do it again, that was brilliant. That was awesome.
Bam!
fantastic stuff. Now,
we're going off a little bit there.
This Dr. Dark guy, who is he? What does he do?
Well, he's like our super villain.
Yeah, well, anybody's super villain, really.
And he's like really, really mean, and he tries to take over everything.
Yeah,
at last, they've remembered what they're here for.
Yeah, he does.
What does he sound like, Dr. Dark? Can you give us some more details on that?
Dr. Dark is like, he's a deep
He got a very deep voice. He sounds like when you were four, like that.
When you were four, like that?
Yeah.
I've heard he's got an interesting laugh.
Yeah.
What does it sound like?
He goes, ha 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 ha.
Here you go. Ha 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 ha
ha. Like that.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, thanks very much for coming in, guys. It's been a pleasure having you on.
Yeah.
Best of luck in the future and good luck chasing Dr. Dark.
The last two into makeup are Princess Paw and Steel Soldier. Will they reveal anything they shouldn't?
How are you?
I'm okay. You, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. I'm Rachel.
Nice to meet
you. What's your name?
Princess Paw.
Princess Paw. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm quite excited.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I prefer to be behind the scenes myself.
You're a makeup artist, so of course.
I know. But I think today these are my first superheroes that I've had to do.
Probably the only you'll ever do. Unless you go on to like work on Batman or whatever.
Yeah, you never know. I might get to go to Hollywood one day.
That's actually the prize if we win the show. You get to go to Hollywood and meet Stan Lee.
Really?
Steel Soldier, he's on a roll. He hasn't stopped talking yet.
So you'd be in Hollywood?
Oh, yeah.
Would you enjoy that?
Of course. Everyone would, unless you actually live there and it's, you know, normal everyday thing and you see the Hollywood Hills, nothing usual, see every day on the doorstep.
Yeah.
But, you know...
But you'd like a bit of that lifestyle.
Yeah, for a Southeast Londoner, you know, to go to Hollywood is a big thing.
Yeah, definitely.
What did he say?
Yeah, for a Southeast Londoner, you know, to go to Hollywood is a big thing.
Yeah, definitely.
Steel Soldier's just told the makeup artist where he's from.
It's big brave, isn't it, being away from home?
Yeah, it's nice though. We're all living a nice life with everyone, so...
So you're all together?
Yeah.
Whereabouts is that then?
I can't say.
Oh, you don't say?
No, I'm not allowed. I'll get in trouble.
Princess Paw, though, is keeping tight-lipped.
Are you happy?
Quite. Yeah, I'm pretty much all
right. Do you want anything else?
Is there anything you can do to get rid of my spots?
Let me just put a little bit of this.
I hate spots. I really hate spots.
Oh, and you want to look your best on the camera as well.
Yeah.
Princess Paw and Steel Soldier have finished in makeup, so let's see how they get on in the interview.
Hello, guys. Welcome to News Round. Thanks so much for coming on.
It's been a pleasure.
Yeah, you're all part of a gang of superheroes protecting the country, right?
Yeah.
Is it true you know Stan Lee?
Sort of.
Yeah.
But we've actually gotten a very important message we'd like to tell the nation.
Princess Paw is keen to talk about Dr. Dark.
Is it true you know Stan Lee?
Sort of.
Yeah.
But we've actually gotten a very important message we'd like to tell the nation.
But she ignored Gavin's question.
What's that message?
Just to warn everyone that Dr. Dark is our
is an evil villain that is after everyone in the nation. We haven't quite worked out what his evil plan is yet.
Right.
And we just want anyone that ever sees Dr. Dark to report him instantly to the police, to any authorities.
Right. And most importantly, not to approach him.
No, he's really dangerous.
Getting the message across is obviously important, but they must do so in a friendly and superhero-like way.
Good superheroes, right? All of them have poses. You know, Batman's got a really cool pose. Superman has. Superman's is like that, isn't it? You know, what's your pose?
Well, I don't actually have a pose, and I don't
really?
Plan to ever get a pose because
sure,
I don't
that's what you're all about.
But
you know, you've got to. How's Dr. Dark going to be scared
off.
Of you?
Superhero isn't because of their pose. You know, you can't just be judged as a good superhero by going like this or this. It's about what you actually
it's
do.
It's what's in our hearts.
It's the job that you do by saving people and helping the public.
Whereabouts is your lair?
Oh, we can't.
We
say
can't
that.
Say that.
We really can't say that.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They certainly made it difficult for Gavin with their guarded approach.
Well, thank you so much for coming in, guys. It's been really good of you to drop by and tell us all that.
Thank you.
And good luck in your missions in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, the main aim of this mission was for the superheroes to warn people about the evil Dr. Dark. But there were also a series of hidden tests. So, how did the superheroes compare? At reception, Gold Starlet, Deflector and Princess Paw all gave away their secret identities.
Is it Ella?
James?
Charlie?
In makeup, Gold Starlet, Pink Puffle Girl and Steel Soldier all told the makeup artist where they live.
So you're from London?
No, from Huddersfield.
Did I detect a Bristol accent there?
Yeah.
Yeah, for a South East Londoner, you know, to go to Hollywood is a big thing.
During their interviews on Newsround, all the superheroes got across their message about Dr. Dark. But at times, Steel Soldier and Princess Poor were a little bit too abrupt.
Is it true you know Stan Lee?
Sort of.
Yeah.
But we've actually gotten a very important message we'd like to tell the nation.
Superheroes, we're glad that you enjoyed that mission and thank you for warning the world about the evil Dr. Dark. Yes, hopefully your appeal will help the authorities track him down and stop him once and for all. Okay, you can now go back to the lair. Off you go, guys.
Coming up, there's some straight talking in the lair.
No offence, but I think you might go up for it, revealing your identity.
What got me the most is that Pink Puffle said to me, I think you're going to be up, but didn't it say Gold Starlet or Deflector to be up?
And one more superhero will leave the lair for good.
We're concerned that you don't seem to have learnt from your past mistakes. Oh, I tell you what, it was nice to be back at the BBC.
Yeah, hey, our superheroes had a busy day, didn't they?
They have, but now it's time to get serious.
Yes, in just a short while, we will be asking one of our superheroes to power down and leave the lair for good.
And for us to make such a big decision first, we must analyse our superheroes' actions during today's missions.
Well, first of all, they did really well in rescuing us from Dr. Dark.
Yeah, that wasn't pleasant.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah, and then they went to News Road.
Yeah.
Very interesting results there. Yeah.
Back up in the lair, the superheroes are talking about their appearance on Newsround.
It was hard because you had to think about every single move you made.
You did.
Right, and at the end, you went, see you later, and you went out to shake a hand, and I was like, should I shake his hand? Yeah.
I think I did really well on that because I didn't spread my secret identity, I didn't spread where I live, didn't spread where the lair is or what's in the lair, so I think I did pretty well.
With some of the superheroes slipping up in today's mission, they talk about who might face the power down.
I think I've got a chance of being up on the pods, but then I've done really well in the riddles and I've done really well in this challenge except for the reception bit. So I'm a bit worried but not overly stressed about it.
I think that Deflector,
no offence, but I think you might go up for it, revealing your identity.
Yeah.
Because they've, like, said it so many times.
But never to me.
Yeah, but still, they said it, and you had to listen to them. And, Steel Soldier.
And me, Gold Starlet, and Deflector. So their name's back at the thing. So I think I've got a chance of being her. But what got me the most is that Pink Puffle said to me, I think you're going to be up, but didn't say Gold Star or Deflector to be up. When Deflector had done really bad in the other task, could Gold Star also revealed her name?
I slipped up at the beginning with these. With where they asked, what's your real name? Blah, 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 blah. Which was just annoying.
Who do you think would be up for Power Down?
Me.
Why? Oh, because... Who else?
Gold Starlet. I'm not saying I think she's going to go up. She thinks she's going up.
I actually really honestly don't know. Because I think everybody gave away something at one point. If I step on the three podiums, I think I'm going to go.
True believers, you know the journey to being a superhero is never easy. And sadly for one of you, that journey is about to come to an end. Believe me when I say that at this stage there are no easy decisions for Sam and Mark to make. Please report to the resolution room and await your fate.
Now, as you know by now, this is the time when we ask one of our superheroes to power down, return back to their secret identity, and leave the lair for good.
But first, Stan Lee has got some information about today's mission.
Superheroes, I hope you all enjoyed your time at the television studio and being in front of the cameras. I want you to know that that was another secret test. I can now tell you that you were being watched at all times, even when you thought the cameras were off. And it wasn't just the studio cameras that were recording. It's amazing where you can hide a hidden camera these days. Sam and Mark, over to you.
Some interesting words from Stan there. And some very interesting reactions from some of you superheroes.
First of all, let's start with your mission to crack the code on the control room door. Thank you again, superheroes, for rescuing us. Goodness knows what would have happened if that laser had got any closer.
It would have hurt.
Yeah, big time.
Pink Puffle Girl. Congratulations on getting 3 of the 4 numbers for the code.
Hey,
1, 6, 6.
Even is in 7. Even's in 7.
Please, can we try 4?
Thank you.
Princess Poor, well done for solving riddle number 3 so quickly.
If you've got a hole and you've how much soil's in it, well, there's no soil in there because it's a hole.
Yeah, because it's a hole.
Even though you'd already heard of that one at school before.
Deflector, you were noticeably quiet during this mission.
Deflector?
What do I know?
Pink Puffle?
3.
3, what do you think?
You didn't seem particularly interested in solving the riddles. Why was this?
I wasn't actually not trying to like join in, I was really trying to think in my head of what it could be. Because I really wanted to pass this mission.
Okay. Teamwork is important for a superhero, and time was of the essence in this particular case. Saving people is the business we're in.
Okay, superheroes, let's move on to your appearance on News Round. Gold Starlet, Princess Poor, and Deflector. When you arrived at BBC Television Centre, you all broke the first rule of being a superhero. Do you know what that was? Princess Poor?
Not to say your secret identity name, even if people there keep pushing you.
Okay, I don't have that. What's your full name?
Is it Ella? James?
Charlie?
When you're dressed as a superhero, and you're out in public as a superhero, you are a superhero. This is page one of how to be a superhero. And it's alarming that at this late stage, you still haven't grasped it.
Now for those hidden cameras that Stan was talking about. Can anyone guess where they might have been?
Oh.
H2O.
In the makeup room.
In the makeup room, SGW, what are you saying?
Yeah, makeup room, still.
Okay. I can now confirm that they were in the makeup room.
H2O man. And SGW. Don't worry, your little makeup secret is safe with us. And the rest of the nation. But, on a more serious note, Steel Soldier, Pink Puffle Girl, and Gold Starlet. During a conversation with the makeup lady, you revealed information about where you're from.
So you're from London?
No, from Huddersfield.
Did I detect a Bristol accent there?
Yeah.
Yeah, from South East London, or, you know, to go to Hollywood, yeah. It's a big thing.
It seems as though every week we're reminding you about not giving away secret information to anyone. This is really disappointing.
Deflector. Again, you were particularly quiet in the makeup room.
You're very quiet, aren't you?
Sorry, I'm a bit chatty.
What's your favourite thing about being a superhero?
I don't know.
You don't know?
It is essential that a superhero is able to interact and communicate well with the public. Unfortunately, you didn't demonstrate that in the makeup room today.
And then there was your actual appearance on News Round. First of all, may we just say that you looked very superhero-like in front of the cameras.
Thank you.
However, was your behaviour that of a true superhero? Overall, superheroes, we both felt that you did incredibly well. You were composed, calm and confident, and demonstrated just how far you have come since you first arrived in the lair.
Princess Paw and Steel Soldier, you were definitely more guarded with your answers than the other superheroes. Although it's good not to give away too much information, Gavin actually found the interview quite difficult because of your reluctance to answer questions.
Is it true you know Stan Lee?
Sort of.
Yeah.
But we've actually gotten a very important message we'd like to tell the nation, if that's possible.
Steel Soldier?
When we do, you know, answer almost any questions, it does lead sometimes give away too much information. So I think we were just a bit wary of whether we did that or not. And I just want to say, you know, if you could say to Gavin that we are sorry if we did seem a bit rude at any time.
We will now ask three superheroes to step forward and face today's power down.
Gold Starlet,
please step forward?
Princess Paul, please step forward.
Deflector, please step forward.
Gold Starlet, you are a dynamic and sparkling superhero. However, revealing your name and hometown in one day certainly wasn't your brightest moment.
I don't have that. What's your full name?
Is it Ella?
So you're from London?
No, I'm from Huddersfield.
And it's not the first time that you've disclosed personal information. This is the reason you are stood before us today.
Please, could you tell us why you think you should remain in the lair?
I can assure you that I will try my hardest and try not to reveal anything, because before I just go around telling people my real name and stuff. But I have actually learned not to. Even if I did go, I'd still be happy that I got far.
Okay, thank you. Princess Paul, you are an honest and considerate superhero. However, your honesty was misplaced today when you revealed your real name.
What's your full name?
Charlie.
Only last week, you divulged the location of your hometown.
Whereabouts?
That's not Bridgewater, Taunton.
Okay.
Oh, I've been there. Oh, it's really nice.
We're concerned that you don't seem to have learnt from your past mistakes. This is why you're standing here now.
Please, could you tell us why you think you should stay in the lair?
I believe that I should stay in the lair because I've learned that a superhero's job isn't just to save people, it's a lot deeper than that. And I've learned that a superhero would never give away their secret identities. And I've also learned that superheroes should always care and put their heart and soul into everything they do. And I really want to learn more right now.
Thank you. Deflector. You are a calm and intelligent superhero. However, you didn't seem to be thinking when you gave your real name to that receptionist. Your lack of participation in the code-cracking mission was surprising to see, especially with so much at stake.
Deflector?
I don't know. Three.
What do you think?
This, combined with your lack of communication in the makeup room.
You're very quiet, aren't you?
Sorry, I'm a bit chatty.
Is why you are standing in front of us today.
Please, could you tell us why you think you should remain in the lair?
It's just the best feeling, being here.
Okay, thanks, mate.
We will now leave the room to make our final decision. We have reached our final decision.
The superhero who will power down and leave the lair is... Deflector.
Deflector, you've been a dedicated and committed superhero, and it's been a pleasure having you in the lair. These decisions really have got harder every week, and this one's been a really tough one.
Deflector, could you please get into position and prepare to power down.
James, now you're back in your secret identity, we can call you James. It's been a pleasure having you in the lair, mate.
and we will miss your golden presence. But now, it's time for you to leave. Gold Starlet and Princess Paw, you are both lucky to survive another power down. With so few superheroes left, it's important that you take on our feedback. Or you could find yourself standing here again next week.
Superheroes, it's been a roller coaster of a day. But for now, you can all go back to the lair and relax. I think you've earned it.
Here you go.
I am very proud to be Gold Starlet right now because nobody else has survived 3 power downs and been here. Yay! I'm still here! I'm happy. I survived another power down.
It was quite emotional for some people.
In a way, the lair will change without Deflector because each time somebody gets powered down, it does, the lair does change.
Do you think they made the right decision?
Yeah, I did. I actually think he didn't want to stay anymore.
I was upset because he did get really upset and it was so upsetting to see him like that. But this is absolutely amazing for him to get this far.
I'm pleased in how I've been a superhero because I thought I did all right in most of the challenges.
I'm gonna miss living in the lab.
Bye, guys! I hope you get Dr. Dark!
Then I'm sorry, Stanley, that I called you a granddad.
So, 7 have become 6 and the battle for comic book immortality continues.
Join us next week for another instalment of Who Wants to Be a Superhero?
Next time, Dr. Dark returns.
This should cause ultimate chaos!
Pushing the superheroes to the limit.
How are we going to do this?
Pull it along.
Okay.
In order to save the day,
don't touch the barrels, it's toxic waste.
We test their super senses. And as the battle to become the next great superhero intensifies, another superhero will power down and leave the lair for good.
The superhero that will power down and leave the lair is
Mega Nannies. They're different.
On the edge.
They're daring. They're dads. And they'll do anything to spend more time with their kids.
Are you ready for a weekend full of surprises?
But have they got what it takes to pull off the ultimate prank and not be rumbled?
I skate and I'm wicked. Girl just wanna
have fun. Undercover Dads, a brand new series, Sundays at 9, CBBC on BBC Two.